गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो वी आर डूइंग ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन. सो लास्टली वी लर्न इन मैथमेटिक्स एक्सरसाइज 1.1 क्वेश्चन 1. नाउ वी आर मूविंग ऑन क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. सो व्हाट क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 सेज? इट सेज इन अ क्विज पॉजिटिव मार्क्स आर गिवन फॉर द करेक्ट आंसर एंड नेगेटिव मार्क्स आर गिवन फॉर द इनकरेक्ट आंसर. इफ जैक स्कोर्स इन 5 सक्सेसिव राउंड, the first round he'll get 25, in second round he'll get -5, in third round he'll get -10, in fourth round he'll get 15, and the last round he'll get +10. So what was his total at the end? So अब हमको क्या करना है, यहाँ पर total पता लगाना है. So first what we'll write, we'll write according to round marks. So let's write first. First round marks is what? 25. Same is second round. Second round marks is what? -5. Same is third. Third round marks is what? -10. Then fourth. Fourth round marks is what? Here 15, and the last round my fifth round marks is what? +10. So now we have to find out total marks. What was his total at the end? So let's find out total marks. Total marks is equal to first round is 25 plus the second round he'll got -5, so we'll write -5 in the bracket, -5 plus in the third round he got -10, so we'll write -10 in the bracket plus in the fourth round he'll get 15, so I'll write this 15, and the last round he'll get 10, so I'll write this 10 here. So as you can see, we need total marks, so we have to add all of them, right? So now what I'll do for simplification, I'll just make them positive on the one side and the negative on the other side. So let's do it. 25 plus another positive is 15 plus another positive number is 10. So what I did, I just took all the positive numbers on the one side. Now negative numbers plus in the bracket -5 plus in the bracket -10. Now just what we have to do, we have to just simplify it. Okay, so 25 plus 15, so it is 40. 40 plus 10, and then this side -10. First I'll remove the bracket, so it will be -5. And this bracket I'll remove, so it will -++, so it will be 10, -10. Now again, 40 plus 10 is what? 50 minus 5 minus 10. Now see, 50 minus 5, 50 minus 5, it is 45. 45 and the left is 10. Now 45 minus 10 is what? Easy, it is 35. So our last answer is 35. So after 5 round he get total 35 marks. So again with the question, I'll repeat. In the quiz, positive marks are given for the correct answer, negative marks are given for the incorrect answer. If Jack scores this 5 round, 25 minus 5 10 15 and 10, सो वॉट वॉज हिज टोटल? सो वॉट वी डिड, हमने यहाँ पर क्या किया, हमने पहले पाँचों राउंड के स्कोर्स लिखे इन द बोर्ड. वी हैव टू राइट द फाइव राउंड स्कोर हियर. आफ्टर दैट वॉट वी डिड, वी हैव टू एड ऑल ऑफ दैम. सो मैंने क्या किया, दो सबको एड कर दिया यहाँ. सो 25 प्लस -5 प्लस -10 प्लस 15 एंड द लास्टली प्लस 10. नाउ जैसे जैसे हम आगे बढ़ते जाएंगे, हमने क्या किया, सिंप्लीफाई किया. again I simplified. How? I took all positive number on the one side and all negative number on the other side. So positive number is our addition of positive number, we got total 50, and the negative number is here. Now lastly we got 35 marks. So we can say that Jax scores total 35 marks after 5 round. Easy? Or that's how you can do all the addition. Now if you don't understand anything, just you have to do this playback and again repeat it. If you don't understand any topic or any addition here, just you have to do playback and again start watching, so you will understand properly. So now we will move on our question number 4. Okay students, so move on our next question, question number 4. So what question number 4 says? A plane is flying at the height of 5000 meter above the sea level. At a particular point, it is exactly above a submarine floating 12000 meter below the sea level. What is the vertical distance between them? So what question want to say? Question keh raha hai ki ek aeroplane sea level se above fly kar raha hai. How much distance par? It is 5000 meter par. Aur ek submarine hai jo ki pani ke niche tair rahi hai sea level ke down side. Kitna down hai? 1200 meter. So bol rahe hai ki question mein bola ja raha hai ki प्लेन और सबमरीन का डिस्टेंस कितना है, टोटल डिस्टेंस बिटवीन प्लेन एंड सबमरीन वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. सो टू डिस्टेंस आर गिवन, द वन इज 5000 मीटर एंड द अनदर वन इज 1200 मीटर, राइट? सो नाउ व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू जस्ट ऐड बोथ द डिस्टेंस, सो वी विल गेट द फाइनल डिस्टेंस बिटवीन एरोप्लेन एंड द सबमरीन. सो फर्स्ट आई विल राइट डिस्टेंस बिटवीन प्लेन एंड द सी लेवल. So plane is flying at how much distance? 5000 meter from sea level, right? So plane is flying 5000 meter above from the sea level. Now second, submarine. Submarine is floating at 1200 meter from the sea level. So now the question is what, yeah, from question is what is the vertical distance between them? Vertical distance kaun sa? Ye wala. From here to here we have in two parts, 5000 meter first and the 12000 meter. So what we have to do, we have to find total distance. So kya karna padega total distance find out karne ke liye? Easy hai, dono ko add kar do to humko total distance mil jayega. So here I'll write the vertical distance between them is equal to what? Is equal to 5000 meter plus 1200 meter, or just you can write this line, plane is flying from the 5000 meter above sea level, or if you don't want to write this tag directly like this. So total we get 6200 meter vertical distance. What is 6200 meter? It is the vertical distance between them. The vertical distance between them is 6200 meter. How we will get? We just add both of them, 5000 meter plus 1200 meter. So here see, the sea, from the sea level, this is the sea level. From the sea level, plane is flying. At this point, plane is flying 5000 meter above and the submarine is floating 1200 meter deep down. So the vertical distance we have to find out. So what we did, we just add both of them. After adding both of them, what we get? we got 6200 meter, and 6200 meter is what? It is vertical distance between them. Easy. If you don't understand any point, just move back and repeat it again. So let's move on our next revision, question number 5. Here the question number 5 says Mohan deposited 2000 rupees in his bank account and withdraw 1642 rupees from it on the next day. If withdrawal of the amount from the account is represented by a negative integer, then how will you represent the amount deposited? And the second question is find the balance in the Mohan's account after the withdrawal. So in one question we have two questions. How? The first question is, if the withdrawal amount from the account represented as a negative integer, then how will you represent the amount deposited? So deposited amount ko kaise consider karenge, either a positive integer or negative integer. And the second question is find the balance in Mohan's account after withdrawal. Ab withdrawal ke baad kitna balance Mohan ke account mein bacha hai, that we have to find out. So first of all we will represent withdrawal and deposited amount. So deposited amount is 2000 rupees. Deposited amount is equal to 2000 rupees, right? So how we will represent it? Suppose deposit means add karna. Add karna means positive. Hum kuch bhi cheez add karte to kya karte usme? Addition karte. Aur agar kuch cheez nikalte to what we have to do? We have to subtract. So here deposit means addition. So we will represent it as positive integer. And the withdrawal. Now withdrawal. Withdrawal amount is, how much withdrawal amount is? 1642 rupees. 642 rupees. So now how will you represent it? As a negative integer. And this one is as a integer. Now so the first question answer is what? Deposited amount we will represent it as positive integer. Now we have to find out second question answer. What is second question says? Find the balance in the Mohan's account after withdrawal. Ab after withdrawal uske paas kitne paise bache hai, that we have to find out. So how can we find out? Just we have to subtract the main amount and the withdrawal amount. Deposited amount and the withdrawal amount. So what is the bigger? Deposited amount is the bigger. So we have to subtract 1642 from the 2000. So the final amount will be 1642 - withdrawal amount. Okay, so deposited amount is what? 2000 rupees. Here so I'll write 2000 minus the withdrawal amount is 1642. So 358 rupees. That is your final amount. The amount which is balance in Mohan's account after withdrawal. So that's it. Again we will do it. What the question says? Mohan deposited 2000 rupees in his bank. After that after one day he'd withdraw the 1642 rupees. So now we have to find out how much balance left in his account. So what we did? We just did subtraction between deposited amount and the withdrawal amount. So for the final balance, we have to subtract deposited amount with withdrawal amount. So From 2000 we subtracted 1642 and the final answer we got 358 rupees. So that's all for today. In the next section or next video we will continue with our next questions.